Let's take a breath now. Let's get a little centered now. I'd like for you to ask yourself, why did I come today in this cold weather? Why did I come today? The Course in Miracles teaches that the goal determines the outcome. If you don't have a purpose, you don't know why you're doing anything you're doing. If you don't have a goal, you're kind of drifting through life. If you don't have a goal, you don't know what's right. Let's breathe. And breathe. Are you ready to hear something that is different from what you normally think? Say yeah.
Yeah.
Even if it's something that's hard for you to believe, are you willing?
Yes.
Because you don't have to believe the ideas. I say it again, you don't have to believe the ideas. You don't have to accept the ideas. You don't have to accept the ideas. You don't have to welcome the ideas. You don't have to welcome the ideas. Some of the ideas you're going to find hard to believe. Some of the ideas you may find quite startling. You don't have to, you're not being asked to judge the ideas at all. You don't have to analyze the ideas at all. If you use it, you will see that it works. Yeah. Breathe. Bring your energy in. I want this class to help you become more prosperous. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Could I have the audacity to want you to have loving relationships? Is that okay?
Yeah.
Is it okay if you have a fulfilling career in the world that doesn't make you want to commit suicide every time the alarm clock goes off in the morning? Is that okay?
Yes.
Take a breath. Do you want to have some fun?
Yes.
Would you like to connect with your source?
Yes.
Would you like to have a relationship with that which created you, that has the power to send to you everything that would fulfill you and allow you to be happy? Would that be okay?
Yes.
Would you like to let go of any guilt? Would
yes.
you like to let go of any fear?
Yes.
Would you like to let go of any depression that
yes.
you're feeling about yes. anything?
Yes.
The name of today's class is called The Little Willingness.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to talk about willingness, the little willingness. Now there's a part of you that doesn't want you to be happy about anything. There's a part of you that likes to kick your butt as much as possible. There's a part of you that doesn't think you deserve any kind of joy. Do you know that?
Yes.
Are you aware of that?
Yes.
Breathe. You are entitled to miracles. You are entitled to miracles. Would it be okay if something loved you more than you love yourself?
Yes.
Would it be okay if something wanted to bring you joy even if you don't think you deserve it?
Yes.
Do you know things don't happen without your consent? That's
yes.
why I'm asking these questions. It's important that you accept a part of yourself, a very powerful part of yourself. This part of yourself has one powerful characteristic that allows things to flow into your life. It's the part of yourself that is juicy. You are juicy. Even if you look dry, feel dry, been dry for 10 years, moldy dry, desert dry, rock dry, Grand Canyon dry, I see your divine juice. You, not only are you juicy, you are sweet. So damn sweet. I'm gonna put you on my pancakes in the morning. Pour you out like you the syrup of God.
Yes.
Is that okay?
Yes.
Can I eat you?
Yes. Yeah.
Even if it's the first time you're here, whether you male, female, young, old, can I consume you,
yes.
join with you, merge with you, love you, free you, breathe. Catching up with myself. I just got back from Chicago late last night. I left Friday, did a workshop yesterday, left last night, and got back. So the last 24 hours, I've been moving. It's been the most incredible, one of the most incredible experiences I've ever had of watching the divine work in my life. Because I was concerned about all the weather stuff that's been going on, you know? And it was so funny. I not only got there, I got there early. And every aspect of the trip went as smooth as I could have imagined that I wanted it to go, because from the time I left in the 7 below 0 weather to go to the airport, I kept saying, this holy instant what I give to you. Be you in charge, for I would follow you, serve in your direction, give me peace. Decide for me, Holy Spirit. Decide for me, loving. Holy Spirit is my divine self, your divine self. You know, it's like I was constantly asking for guidance, constantly asking for the divine to be in charge of it. Because I used to always think I had to be in charge of it. And so I was always trying to figure out how I could make it go smooth. And I knew it's about surrender. Every lesson is about surrender. So I went there. Everything was great, picked up very smoothly. It was a trip in Chicago as far as the cold, because it's a wet cold as opposed to a dry cold. It was 20 degrees in Chicago. Anybody knows what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
You know,
that
was like, it was like the Hulk was like, I'm gonna get you, black man. You gonna be praying for that African blood you got inside. You're gonna have to turn it up. And Holy Spirit blessed me with so many wonderful opportunities, and I got so many answers to so many things I was praying about and asking about, and I was allowed to get the divine plan for the next part of my life. And I met this incredible teacher that I was at her house, and she walked in the door. I'd never met her. I was sitting there before she got home, and she walked in the door, and she just started channeling. As soon as we met, she just started channeling, and she was answering every single thing I had been asking about. It was amazing. And so I got the whole divine plan laid out. Then I went to the place that I was supposed to speak, and the guy that I was, really incredible guy that I was doing the workshop with, named Joe Wolf, he has a prison ministry where he's sending the Course in Miracles to prisoners, because he had been in prison when he was in his 20s, and he told his incredible story of the transformation that he went through that blew my mind. And then there was some people that came to the thing that had been watching, a lot of them had been watching the videos that I put online of my classes, and so they walked in and they were so excited to get a chance to connect with me, and they just came in there totally loving and totally open, and it was very diverse group of people, you know, black, white, you know, Indian from India, and all kind of folk, and they were all ready to play and ready to learn and ready to challenge and ready to love. Then I had to rush out to go to the airport after it was over, and somebody volunteered to take me really quick that was faster, and I got there, and it was time, and as soon as I walked in the terminal, I looked at my boarding pass, and it had on there TSA pre-check. And so I said, that's interesting. I went to the TSA pre-check line instead of the regular security line, and they said because I was TSA pre-check, I didn't have to take off my belt, I didn't have to take off my coat, I didn't have to take off my shoes, I didn't have to take out my laptop, I didn't have to take out the toiletries out of my... I just walked through. Remind me of the olden days. I was like, Holy Spirit, you kicking ass! And then I got on the airplane, and then I could just chill out, because I didn't have, and as soon as I walked in, it's like the place to go through the security was, as soon as I walked in, it was right there, the pre-check. As soon as I walked in, I wasn't familiar with the guard. And so I went in, so I went through, got me a turkey sandwich, a holy meal, and I sat down, and I had like an hour and a half just to chill out, cool out, relax, and get ready for the trip back to Denver, you know. And it was sunshine, and now they got the ice and snow we had here that's hitting them today. But it was sunshine when I left, right? Got on the jet to fly back here. I don't have packed their bin because they cut back usually, so you know, usually have a lot of people now, and a lot of empty seats. I had a whole row to myself. Whole row! Wow. I just came back with my legs over the chair. Kicking on. And I was like, Holy Spirit, you kicking ass! I love fulfilling my function. Just being willing to be a conduit of love and truth, you know?
Yes.
God, man. Got two other speaking engagements out of it. And made some new friends. They can't wait for me to get back. And it completely slammed me against my upper limit. That part of you when it's just so good, you get to the part of you that doesn't even think you can handle it anymore. And then I had something else happen. Then I got, as soon as I got out of the airplane, I had parked in this super shuttle, the canopy off parking place where they pick you up in the shuttle and take you back to where your car is, right? And y'all, it was cold. As soon as I walked out of the building to go wait for the shuttle was there. The shuttle, I didn't have to wait 2 seconds. And then there you were, just sitting there. Then I got on the shuttle. Then they had another miracle. Went there, then I put my key in the car to crank it up, and it cranked. Now, y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all know what I'm saying? And I talked to Laro, that's the name of my car. Everything has consciousness, you know. So I talked to my car, thank you for cranking up, and you know, and it's a female car, so I get her to warm up pretty quick. I know exactly where to rub the muffler. So I'm grateful. And then to top it off, I come here today and see you.
Amen.
Ooh, can we just acknowledge ourselves?
Yeah.
It's cold. It's cold. You can be at home, you can be warm. And then the thing that's really got me blown away, it's the day of a Broncos game in people here, you know. And some people, that doesn't mean anything. Some people I know, it meant that they were committed that they're here today. So I'm just full of gratitude. And I'm excited about, you know, I got a birthday coming up soon. So I'm leaving Tuesday to go visit my family. I want to spend my birthday with my family, my brothers and my brother and my three sisters. And then my two siblings is out of the body. that's always with me, and I'm excited about that. I got a grandson that I'm meeting for the first time that I've never seen before. He's like 7 months old. I've never seen him. He don't know. His granddad is a trip. Oh boy, you in for something. I'm telling you, you know.
Why you think we wanted to be born, granddaddy?
Yeah. They thought I was going to save him. and silently, lovingly. And so I want to feel that little bit of willingness, and I want everybody around me to have that same type of experience. But the key to my spiritual growth would have been, had everything not worked out that way, could I have still maintained my peace, my joy, and my gratitude? Because you can't make your happiness dependent on your script always being acted out the way you want it to be acted out. That's phony happiness. See, most people are happy because they think the script that they want for that particular day has gone the way that they want it to go, and so therefore they are happy. That's not real happiness. That's conditional happiness based on everything being under your control at a conscious level. The real test is what I was working on, was if I'm going to surrender to this trip, and I'm going to take responsibility for whatever happens, and I'm going to ask for guidance no matter what happens. That was my goal when I left out the house. Not that everything would necessarily go exactly like I wanted it to go, but that no matter what happened, I would have the right perception of it, so that I wouldn't lose my peace and be able to deal with whatever happened. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. You know, so don't fool yourself into thinking that being spiritual and being conscious means that everything's going to go the way you think you need it to go all the time. Because in order to grow spiritually, you're going to sometimes introduce your own challenges just to see if your peace comes from within or what is totally based on everything seeming to go the way you want it to go in the outer, which is phony peace. That's phony peace. We want the real deal, right? So the section that I'm doing in the Course in Miracles is called The Little Willingness. The Little Willingness is in chapter 18, section 4. It's on page 380 if you have the book. If you don't have the book, I got 3 loaner copies up here if you want to follow along in the book that you can borrow. And also, if you don't have the book, it's a possibility that you don't have the book.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Now, the Course in Miracles uses a lot of Christian terminology to describe universal spiritual truths. I'm going to give you the modern language version of it by giving you the Course in Miracles definitions of those words. Like it says holy, where the Course says that means happy, that means loving. So I'm going to read it and then elaborate on it, but I'm going to do it in a way that hopefully will help you get past any resistance to the terminology, because it's more important to me that you get the content of it than being hung up on the form of it. Is that cool?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. So, now I want you to think about, you'd like to experience happiness. You want to experience joy. And it says, the happy instant is the result of your determination to be happy. Mm-hmm. I'll say it again. Do you know that your happiness is the result of your determination to be happy? It said determination to be happy. It said sort of, maybe, no juice, no fire, no passion. It said it's your determination to be happy. And it is the answer. The answer is your joy. The answer is your determination. So I left with the determination to be happy. I had a lot of resistance to going at first. You know, I'm one of these people that I like to be there. It's not the whole. Okay. Now, there was a very interesting spiritual lesson in what just occurred that Spirit wanted me to share.
You got the TSA, you don't get the video?
What'd you say?
I said you got the TSA out, you don't get the video out?
It's now, notice I was talking about how easy, how smoothly, how wonderfully things had gone.
Yes.
And the Course says we have a tendency to believe that any kind of happiness or peace or joy that we have has to be paid for by some kind of suffering that comes later. So you have a good time, and you have to follow it up with something that's some kind of a challenge or some kind of problem to pay for the pleasure you just had. So as soon as I was talking about, oh, things been going so good, and going so smooth, then what happened? Boop, all hell broke loose with the camera, right? Yeah, so that was supposed to be, so I had to pay for that good time that I had, but I had to have something look like it was going wrong. But then I decided to choose for peace anyway. Remember that I'm still in front of my friends and I'm still in front of myself. So I have to go through that, oh, that just seems so unprofessional. I have to stop right in the middle of what you're doing and all that. Was like, that's a bunch of crap. So now.
Thank God.
Now let's go back. Okay, so happiness is a result of the determination to be happy. So the desire and the willingness to let the happiness come precedes its coming. So your happiness is not going to come until you have the desire, right? But desire is willingness. They're not different. So many times people will say they have the desire, but they're not willing to do anything. I had to be willing to get on the plane. I had to be willing to go teach. I had to be willing. The happiness was there exterior, in the exterior and the interior, because I was willing, right? And so you prepare for the happiness. You prepare for peace only to the extent of recognizing that you want it above all else. I'll say that again. How do I prepare myself for what it is I say I want? Well, the truth teaches you have to want it above all else. You have to want your peace and your happiness above wanting that person. If it comes down to a choice between your happiness and a person, you have to choose your happiness. You have to want your happiness above the job, above the money, above the career, above everything. You have to want your peace and your joy. It's not necessary that you do more. Now, how does that hit? It's not necessary that you do more than want it above all else. Okay, now think about that for a minute, and I bet you will also see why you're not happy. Because if you'll be honest with yourself, you probably compromise and don't choose your happiness above all else. You put somebody else first. You put something else first. You think after you get this or that, then your happiness will be there. Maybe I'm not doing the things that's necessary to get me to the state of mind that I would want my happiness for all. More than anything else, I'm not doing my spiritual practice. I'm not doing my spiritual study. I'm not forgiving. I'm not letting go of my blocks and my grievances. I'm not loving myself the way I should. I'm not to the point that I want my peace, my joy, from within me, above all else. The reason why I think the Course in Miracles says it's not necessary to do more is because that's a full-time job. Changing your mind to the point that you're willing for the blocks to be gone, that you really want your love, your truth, your peace, your happiness above all else, that's a full-time job. And the Course then says, Now, not only is it not necessary that you do more than recognize you want it above all else, it says it's also necessary that you realize you cannot do more than want it above all else. It's necessary to realize that it's not necessary to do more than want your happiness and peace above all else, and it's also necessary that you realize that you can't do more than want it above all else. Do not attempt to give the Holy Spirit, your own divine self, your own greater self, your own higher power, okay, what your higher power does not ask. Your higher power is not asking for you to come up with the plan. Your higher power isn't asking you to figure out how the happiness is going to get to you. Your higher power is not trying to get you to come up with the person who's going to make you happy or the situation. It's saying that your job is to want it above all else, because if you try to get in charge of any part of it, you will add your ego to the divine, and you'll confuse the two, and you'll be following your plan instead of God's. That's very important. I didn't know I was going to get a pre-check. I know I wanted a smooth flight home, and I wanted peace coming home. Spirit took care of some of the details that made that easy. I didn't know the guy was going to take me to the airport that took me to the airport earlier than I would have been able to go originally. But I knew I wanted to go, and I wanted to have a peaceful trip, and I kept telling Spirit, you be in charge, 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 you be in charge. I want this above all else. I want a peaceful trip above all else. I want a peaceful trip above all else. And then Spirit took care of the details. How is not your business. And that's the main thing we always try to do. It's the how. It's the goal that's our business. It's the purpose that's our business. It's us wanting it above all else that's our business, not the how. So how does the average person do it, right? This is the way the average person does it. They kind of half-ass ask for something, and then they get busy trying to make it happen. But they're not really passionate about the purpose of the goal. They're not focusing all day long on what is the goal, what is the goal, what is my purpose, what is my purpose. I want my purpose of peace. I want my purpose of joy. I want my purpose of happiness. I'm focusing on my purpose. What can I do to make sure my purpose happens? They're focusing on how is it going to happen. And then when you say, what do you want? It's like my friend Maureen said, the lady that I told you about. It's like, is this something that you would do in the dark, in the cold, and there was no money connected to it? What is it that you would do with passion if there was no kind of external reward that you were thinking about? If you don't have a passion about something, if you don't have a thing that you love, I would teach whether there's any money coming in or not. And that's happened with quite a few classes. Barbara Streisand said she would sing whether she was making any money or not. If you're doing it just for the money and you're doing it just for your... What's that?
I'm sorry.
That's okay. I personally have never had my phone go off in a place that I wish it hadn't. So I'm going to crucify you. Get out of here! That's okay, baby. That just means that's something I need to really pay attention to when I look at the video. That's just, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I'll say it one more time. Find your passion. Find your passion. Don't operate strictly from your security center. That you're doing everything for security or for money or for someone trying to make you feel valuable and special, but not because it's coming from a burning passion inside yourself in terms of what it is you want and what you want to do. The next time you say you want to do something and you don't feel it, then know you're kidding yourself. Mm-hmm. If you say you want a relationship and you don't feel it, or you say you want a new career and you don't feel it, and you say you want to love yourself more and you don't feel it, the next time you say you want anything and you don't feel it, know you don't really want it.
Yes.
You just call in words. Mm-hmm. You know, this is something I work on every day. I study every day. I study the course every single day. I got friends I study with. This is my passion, and your passion creates. It's my passion that took me to Chicago. It's my passion that's taking me to France. It's my passion for what I'm doing. It's not me laying back, sort of wanting to do it just because I'm miserable on my job, so just give me another one, because as soon as you get another one, you're gonna not like it in a few months either. You know I'm telling the truth. So your first job has got to be to determine what it is that you want. Now, first you want peace, right? And then you want connection with source so that you can have I couldn't have done all of that. Something larger than me was in charge of that. So I need to get in touch with something greater than myself. And then it says here that your part is to be determined to have it. Okay, so I'm getting ready to do a whole new, where am I at now? How do I want to do my career now? How do I want to do my teaching ministry now? What changes do I need to make in the way I do things for me to stay passionate and excited about it? So I'm going to be making changes in my life and allowing changes in my life over the next 90 days in very big ways because I want to keep my enthusiasm and excitement going. So I'm going to get clear about what I want and then learn how to listen more so I can experience it. What's Earl's passion now? Because it's who you are right now. Not who you were last week, a month ago, 6 months ago, 6 years. Who are you today? And what is the passion of the you are today? And if you don't know, that needs to be your first priority, is finding out what the heck that is. You are an unlimited God being, created by a God being. There is nothing you can't do, nothing you can't have. That's the truth about us. Then we go, well, why isn't it happening? Because of everything you've learned to the contrary, that you believe about yourself that's not true, that's why it's not happening. I answered that, didn't I? Yeah, that mystery is solved. Why isn't it happening? The way you think, that's why it's not happening. Well, how do I make it different? You give yourself a new way of thinking. How do I do that? I repeat new ways of thinking to myself over and over again until I start to consider it more and more. Until I finally believe it, and then when I believe it, I see it. How else do I do that? You don't compare what you want to where you are now, because where you are now is the result of the way you were thinking before, so you can't compare your present situation to what you say you want to prove that you can't have it. Got to let go of that, too.
Yes.
You know, you say you want to experience your prosperity and abundance, but you're so broke right now, so poor you can't pay attention. Then you can't compare your present financial situation to the one that you say you want. You have to understand that the one you're experiencing now is a result of what you've been telling yourself in the past, and now you're telling yourself something new now, and you're working on it now. Are you with me?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Now, now your higher self just asks what little of you. How many of you can do little?
Yes.
Everybody who can do little. Who's good at little? Okay, all right. Good. Perfect. This is our path, isn't it? God is so good. God came up with a path for the people who want to do little. That's great, isn't it? All right. Then it says, Holy Spirit asks but little. It is the God, the divine, who adds the greatness and the might. Your greater self, the divine, joins with you to make the happy instant far greater than you can understand. Mm-hmm. So are you willing to be happier than you can understand?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, that's a big level of happiness. I'm so happy I don't even understand why. Okay, and have you been around people like that? That you were just happy and you didn't even understand why, or you were in a situation that you were happy and you didn't even understand why. You were just, you know, sometimes you just stopped at a traffic light and you just feel good for no reason and scare yourself half to death. Right? Because we always think there's got to be a reason to feel happy. And then when true happiness starts to happen to you, it will just burst forth for no apparent reason at all. Mm-hmm. It won't be because you got the house, you got the car, you got the maid or whatever. You just, it'll come from you from within. And you just feel happy. And don't let that shock you when it breaks through. It's been trying to break through all your life. Mm-hmm. Okay? Also, it says, Holy Spirit, your loving self, your divine self, joins with you to make the happy instant far greater than you can understand. It is your realization that you need do so little that enables the universe to give so much. Ooh, I love that. Mm-hmm. It's the realization I need to do so little. I love that he says that enables God to give so much. The realization that I need to do so little, what is the so little I need to do? Be determined to be happy and to have the holy instant above all else. And he says, if you do that, I can give it to you because now you're in the beginner's mind and you are not interfering with your plan. Your plan is interference. Your plan is the interference. Suppose love wants to get to you through somebody that would be the perfect person for you to experience love through, but you've decided that it's somebody that is not the perfect person for it to come through, and Spirit wants to give it to you through the perfect person for you, then your desire for the person that's not best for you is interference. Your plan to have it your way, at that point, is interference. Mm-hmm. Suppose your abundance could come to you a way that you didn't even understand or think of, but you're busy thinking it's going to come through the plan that you've made up. Then your plan is interference. Well, how do I know if my plan is interference? It ain't working. It ain't working. You're busy trying to make it happen. You're going to classes and workshops so that you can get more information so that you can make it happen. And that's the mistake that adults make. They try to get more knowledge so that they can be more in charge instead of learning how to get rid of the blocks between them and their divine guidance and their divine self that will show them exactly what to do.
Amen.
That's the truth. Adults think it's up to them to figure it all out. And that's when you get brought to your knees.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you get brought to your knees. So that you would get to the point that you say, decide for me, God. Decide for me, universe. Whatever word you want to use. I'm cool with God now. Mm-hmm. But you might have another word that you need to use. But I'm going to use God. Mm-hmm. Okay? So every day through the course, I'm working on surrender. I'm working on listening. I'm working on getting rid of the blocks. And even more, getting rid of the blocks in me that would tell me I don't deserve it. Mm-hmm. That I'm not worthy of it. Mm-hmm. Because when those things start to show up, you won't let it in if you don't think you deserve it. So your blessings could show up and you would not even let them in. As a matter of fact, you wouldn't even see the person that was loving you. Mm-hmm. They could be standing right there and you wouldn't see them. Mm-hmm. Whew. Mm. The Course in Miracles says, there is nothing so blinding as the perception of form. I was like, that's an interesting statement. There's nothing so blinding as the perception of, hey, I'm all about looking at the form. Aren't you? Look around right now. Just look at your fast form. Come on, look. Don't feel embarrassed. You know you're going to look anyway. Just go ahead and do it. Okay. All right. Now, does that tell you anything about that person? Really? Absolutely. That's why he says it's blinding. You're looking at the form, but you know nothing about the content, so you're really not seeing them until you see their mind, where they're coming from. So I have gotten blinded by the form. You know, I've had many a butt turn me into Stevie Wonder. Just this morning. Okay, that's a whole other story. We won't get into that. You know what I'm talking about, right? You see that form, you get blind. That's what he said. He says the form is the outside of everything. And that's why it's blinding. I just see the outside of everything. So I'm not really seeing you until I see the inside. Interesting. Now, form follows consciousness. Form follows content. Form follows purpose. So therefore, the form of what you want will automatically be taken care of, and it will be the best form if you're clear about what your purpose is. A person that you love and that you feel love with can't come in the wrong form. They're never mutually exclusive. I love you, but I hate your body. Mm-hmm. That don't work. It doesn't work that way. Mm-hmm. I don't love you and I hate your body. Mm-hmm. I just want your form. And I hate your body. Yes, I want the form, I hate the body, so now I don't want you. Well, it wasn't never me you wanted. It was the form you wanted. That's why we work so hard to make sure the form is looking good. Because there are many people that just want you because of your body and the way your body looks. Don't look at me like you don't know what I'm talking about. Have you ever wanted somebody because of their form? Say yes. I love how when the truth pegs us, we are like, I don't know what you're talking about. That's the biggest bunch of crap. Like, I don't know what you mean. I'm always looking at the person's inside first. Okay, I got you a date with the Hunchback of Notre Dame. All three of us. Be real with yourself now. Be honest, right? So I'll say it again. You're realizing you need do so little other than be absolutely certain that you want it above all else is what allows the universe to give it to you. And the Course says, trust not your good intentions. This is so deep. Mm-hmm. Don't trust your good intentions. Don't trust your good intentions. Don't trust your good intentions. Your good intentions are not enough. 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 So what should I trust if I'm not going to trust my good intentions? Trust implicitly your willingness. See, I don't trust my intentions anymore, but I trust that I am willing to want to practice the truth above all else. I'm trusting that I'm willing to listen to spirit more than I ever have in my life. I'm trusting that I'm willing to try to be a more loving person than I've ever been in my life. I'm trusting that I do trust that I'm willing. But I don't trust your good intentions, and I don't trust my good intentions, because people have been harmed so much by people's good intentions. Somebody get hit in an accident, and they laying out there, and somebody with good intentions moves them and snaps their spinal cord. It was a good intention. So good intentions don't guarantee that you're doing the thing that's really cool. So don't trust your good intentions. Don't trust good intentions. Trust your willingness to finally be happy. Trust your willingness to really finally know what it is you're on this planet to do. Because once you decide that you're going to really fulfill your spiritual function, the Course in Miracles teaches that everything else, including the money that you need, will be given to you. So if you're struggling, you're not fulfilling your function. If you're struggling, you're not fulfilling your true function. If you're struggling, you're not fulfilling your true function. If you're struggling, you're not fulfilling your true function. If you're struggling and unhappy, you're not fulfilling your true function. What is my true function? My true function is to be a conduit for love, for peace, for awareness, for spirit, for freedom, for abundance on this planet. To be a living expression of love. And I have to want to be that above all else. And when I want to be that above all else, then I'll be given everything that I need to stay in joy and peace. That's a good deal. That sounds like, would that work for you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay,
yes.
All right. So that means our job is to what? Get rid of everything that keeps us from staying on top of the fact that our happiness must be our primary goal above all else. Even if the world says you're being selfish, even if the world says you're being selfish, even if the world says you're being selfish, because usually the people who are calling you selfish are not happy themselves. It's amazing how many broke people that try to tell you what to do with your money. It's amazing how many people that don't have a relationship will tell you what's wrong with yours. It's amazing how many people who haven't achieved the peace and joy and happiness themselves and have so many opinions about how you're doing your thing. Wow. So in order to be happy, in order to be truly happy, one of the first states of consciousness that you have to cultivate is not caring what other people
yes.
think.
Yes.
As long as you are an accommodator, you'll never know your joy.
Yes.
Accommodators never are happy.
Yes.
I'm glad that that's thrilling you. Check out the people who are happy, and in a lot of cases, they're the people that people are calling selfish.
Mm-hmm.
It might be a connection.
Mm-hmm.
They're not selfish.
No.
They're actually being unselfish. Because people who are happy and allow themselves to have their prosperity and their joy and what fulfills them, those are the people who have something to give. Those are the people who have something to share. Those are the people that can be used to bring happiness to other people. If you don't have nothing, what you gonna give? How are you gonna make somebody else happy and you're a miserable, sad person? How are you gonna be generous to people and you don't know how you're gonna pay your next bill? There is absolutely zero spirituality with poverty. And lack. So every time you say, I'm going to go for my happiness and my peace and my joy above all else, you are loving yourself. You are loving yourself. So, The last thing I'm going to say is, trust your willingness, whatever else may enter. Concentrate only on your willingness, and do not be disturbed that shadows, which is doubt and fear, surround it. So that's really good. I want you to hear this. Concentrate on the fact that you want to be happy above all else, and don't worry if you still have some doubts about it and you still have some fear about it, because that's okay. Like it just says here, concentrate only on this, but don't be disturbed that there are shadows about it. Don't be disturbed because you may not feel 100% right now. Don't be disturbed by that. Your goal is to want it above all else. So there's a line in the course where it says, happiness is a decision I must make. Heaven is a decision I must make. Happiness is a decision I must make. Love is a decision I must make. Abundance is a decision I must make. Happiness is a decision, it's not an outer circumstance. I decide to have a good day, I have a good day. If I don't decide to have a good day, I won't have a good day. But if I say I'm going to have a good day, if this happens, now I'm setting myself up. But I could just decide that I'm going to be happy today. I'm going to decide I'm going to have peace. And that's what I did on that trip. I said, no matter what's going to happen, I'm deciding that I'm going to give myself peace. No matter what happens, I'm going to do the best I can. I'm going to give myself peace. So your happiness is a decision you must make. Your happiness is a choice you must make. And I want you to decide. I invite you to decide. I will support you every way I possibly can in that decision that you have for happiness. I'll be here every way I possibly can to support you in that decision. But I can't run down the field with you, and I can't carry the ball for you. But I'm totally willing to be there with you and supporting you every way I possibly can in doing it. So I want to connect up with the people who have had enough and are ready to take it to another level and know their peace and their happiness. And I believe that's you. In my heart, I believe that's you. Thank you. God bless you. Yeah. To acknowledge yourself for what you did today. Lord have mercy. Okay, we're going to do the financial expression of appreciation. Thank you. With my full-time ministry with the course, I appreciate you all so much. Thank you. I put all my classes on YouTube and on my website. Got over 700 classes on my website. I do one-on-one sessions with people to help you, coach you, mentor you on how to do this stuff. And I use also my knowledge of astrology and numerology for people who are open to that, as well as the course in truth. On my website, earlpurdy.com, it explains it. We can do a one-on-one together. Those of you online, if you want to make a financial expression of appreciation, go to earlpurdy.com. I love y'all. So anybody need to sign the contact list so that I can add you to my mailing list, so that I send out links with these classes. And also I can let you know if for some reason the weather is saying I'm not going to be here. So if you go to my website, my phone number is on it. And when I'm not going to be here because of weather, then I'll put a message on my machine and you just call. Is that fair enough? So to go to my website for all my contact information. Next Sunday is my birthday, but I'll be in Memphis. But Anna Kajawa is going to do the class for me next Sunday. She's an incredible Course in Miracles teacher. So give yourself that treat. Check her out. She's bad. She's bad. She's really, really bad. She's awesome. That's my girl. Okay, so take a breath. I got a very deep affirmation I'm going to say for 2 minutes. Let yourself hear this. Don't trust your good intentions. Your good intentions are not enough. But trust implicitly your willingness, whatever else may enter. Do you hear that? God will join with you. We'll take care of all the details, but you have to want it above all else. You have to want it above all else. So what do I want? You have to ask yourself a million times today, this week, go, what do I want? What do I want? What do I want? What do I really want? What do I really want? What do you 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 really, 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 really want? You can tell what it is by how you feel. You can tell what it is by how you feel. You can tell what it is by how you feel. How do you feel? When you mention it, how do you feel? When you mention it, how do you feel? When you say it, how do you feel? Allow it? Will you allow it? Will you allow it? Will you allow it? Are you willing to learn how to let go of every block to your receiving it? You got to do your spiritual practice. You got to do your spiritual practice. If you want to let go of those old mindsets that block you in every way, you have to do some spiritual practice. You have to focus on your spiritual practice. You have to focus on your relationship with your higher self. It's not going to happen. It's not just going to happen because you just sit back and don't do something to show that you have a willingness to have it. You have to do something to show you have a willingness to have it, which is you have to want it above all else. What do you want above all else? What do you want above all else? What do you want above all else? You are entitled to miracles. You are entitled to miracles. The past is over. It can touch you not. Your past is over. No matter how it's been in the past, it doesn't have to be that way anymore. So tell yourself, I have reached my limit. 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 I want another way to look at this. I have reached my limit. I want another way to look at this. So right now, ask for something you want silently. And it could be just happiness and peace. But if there's something you know you want right now, nobody's listening, so really ask for it. And if you don't feel excited when you ask for it, if you don't feel turned on when you ask for it, lay it over to the side because it's not a true desire. And here's the affirmation. You deserve to be paid for having fun. You deserve to be paid for having fun. I deserve to be paid for having fun. I deserve to be paid for having fun. Anybody don't mind saying it? I deserve to be paid for having fun. What? I deserve to be paid for having fun. Yeah. I deserve to be paid for having fun. I deserve to be paid for having fun. I deserve to be paid for. Now we're going to also say it for each other because that also has a lot of power. So we're going to say you for everybody else. You deserve to be paid for having fun. You deserve to be paid for having fun. You deserve to be paid for having fun. You deserve to be paid for. Now what about we? Hey, we deserve to be paid for having fun. We deserve to be paid for having fun. We deserve to be paid for a little juice in there. We deserve to be paid for having fun. We deserve to be paid for all up from my toe. We deserve to be paid for having fun. Yeah, we deserve to be paid for having. Then you say that magical term goes like this. Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. What? Go ahead, go ahead. Tell spirit, go ahead, go ahead. Tell you what? Go ahead, 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 and breathe. So I love y'all. I appreciate with y'all. Tuesday night, 7 o'clock, I'll be doing a Way of Mastery class here. That's an awesome class. That's also online. And I want to say, may the course be with you. I appreciate y'all. Hugs are available. I love hugs. Have a really cool day. You deserve to be paid for doing what you love. I'll be here Tuesday night. Yeah. No, I'm leaving on Wednesday, on the 11th. I'm glad you mentioned that. I'll be here Tuesday night. All right. Okay.